G'day, I'm Warren Logie, and this is Christmas.
Like any major city in December, the Christmas decorations are taken out of storage and returned to the streets to terrorise the eyes with their garish colours and grotesque features. The very sight of these decorations sends shoppers to run for cover and spend more money.
This is called the circle of life, and it moves us all, just like the police do if you try to sleep on one of our Brisbane City Council benches.
But Christmas in the city is much more than just the council's decorations. It's usually about Melbourne's secondhand decorations in the form of the Myer Christmas window. In this grand tradition, we receive a two-year-old, very Melbourne-specific story display that is vaguely about Christmas. Highlights from previous years include a vomiting pig and the time they recreated a Myer commercial in its entirety. But as much as I complained about the display, this year's lack of display is downright disgusting and makes me long for a pig vomiting into a Myer bag on a tram in the window instead. On the other side of the mall, arch-rival David Jones is a lot less cheery, as their Christmas display was stolen by Jim Carrey in the year 2000 as he undertook research for his appearance in the film The Grinch. The display was never recovered and the cost to replace it was too high, so they came up with this instead. As always, City Hall dazzles us with its festive decorations and has become increasingly sophisticated, especially after they removed the world's ugliest Christmas tree. At night, the hall comes to life with a dazzling display of projections brought to you by community organisation Golden Casket. If all of this is too gaudy for you, then I suggest you avoid Roma Street Parkland's Enchanted Garden. See what the parklands would look like if Brisbane was the city from Blade Runner.
And who could forget Brisbane's greatest Christmas tradition, tinsel posting.
This tradition goes back to the 1970s, where local children would shoplift tinsel, wrap it up in full-priced Myer wrapping paper, cover it with compliments, and shove it unaddressed into a postbox. No one knows what it was meant to symbolise, but the tradition continues to this day. Each year, the Brisbane City Post Office donates the tinsel to a major cake decorating company, and that is how edible ball bearings are made.
I'm Warren Logie, and this was Christmas.